So as usual, we're going to make a inventory of concepts in the game. This time I'm going to try to break things out a little bit, and I'm going to talk about low-level concepts, high-level concepts, and mid-level concepts. And as we saw in the discussion forums, it's always a question of where do you want to start? Do you want to describe the low-level first and build up from there? Do you want to describe the high-level first and build down? But I think for this case, we'll take more of a middle-out approach. So at the mid-level, there's the concept of current state of the game. We're sort of inching towards a search problem, and we know that we have to represent states for a search problem, so we want to know the current state of the game. If we're thinking of search problems, then we also have to know about actions we can take, and we know that there's two actions, roll and hold. So here's some candidates for what's in the current state. First, the things that were on the scoreboard. So the scoreboard, remember, had three things. Then, the player whose turn it is, we might want that to be part of the state. The previous roll of the dice, whether I just rolled a five or something else, that might be part of the state. And the previous turn score, how much did the other player just make on their turn? So all of these are possibilities. You might be able to think of other possibilities, but I want you to tell me which one of these are necessary to describe the state of the game. And I guess I should say here that we're assuming that the goal of the game, the number of points you need to win, we're assuming that that's constant and doesn't need to be represented in each individual state. We just represent it once for the whole game. Which of these are necessary for the current state?